Hey everyone, it's Justin. In this lesson, we'll be talking about how to find slope between only two points. Okay, so really we've already learned how to find a slope between two points. We just pick two points out of this table, find the change in y and the change in x, and then divide change in y over change in x. If we had a graph, we'd pick two points and just find rise over run. The only part that will be new in this lesson is that the questions will look a little different, and we'll use a slightly different version of the same slope formula. Here's what I mean. The question just gives you the coordinates of two points, and nothing else. We could organize these in a kind of pseudo table form and do it that way, but why do the same thing over and over when we can learn something new? There is actually a third version of the slope equation, and that's what we'll use this time around. We know that the slope is the change in y over the change in x, and we can also find it using rise over run. And now we'll be finding it using y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. I know that looks kind of confusing, but let me show you how simple that actually is. First, let's just talk about what this notation means. The ones and twos just tell us which point to use, the first or the second. So one means the first point, and two means the second point. Then, of course, the x or y just means which coordinate to use. So the x of the first point is x1, and the y from that point is y1. And same for the second point, x2 and y2. Now that we know which variables stand for which numbers, we just plug them in. y2 is 4 minus y1, which is 2, over x2, which is 3, minus x1, which is 1. If we subtract on top and bottom, we get 2 over 2, which is 1. So the slope of the line that goes through both of these points is just 1. Let's do a few more examples, starting with this one. Here's the slope formula again, in case you need it. First, let's label the coordinates so we know which ones to plug in where. The x of the first point is x1, and the y of the first point is y1. The x of the second point is x2, and the y of the second point is y2. Plug them into the formula. Be careful with your calculations here. Negatives can be kind of tricky. Remember, when you subtract a negative, it's the same as adding a positive. So that's really 4 plus 2, which is 6. And on the bottom, negative 3 minus negative 1 is the same as negative 3 plus 1, so that's negative 2. And then 6 divided by negative 2 is negative 3. So the slope of this line here would be negative 3. Let's do a few more quick examples. From now on, I won't write which value goes with which variable. After some practice, you should be able to recognize them without having to write it all out. So you've got y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. 12 minus 5 is 7, and 3 minus negative 2 is like saying 3 plus 2, so that's 5. And since this doesn't divide evenly, we can leave it as a fraction. 7 fifths, or 7 over 5. Notice how when we set up the slope formula, we always go in the same direction with the x's and y's from the points. With the y's, we did second point minus first point, and the same for the x's. Make sure you always go in the same direction for both. If we instead did first then second with the x's, we would have gotten the wrong slope. Here's our next example. Negative 8 minus 4 over 6 minus 2. Negative 8 minus 4 is negative 12, and 6 minus 2 is 4. The slope of this line would just be negative 3. All right, last one. Don't get tripped up by 0. Remember, it's just another number on the number line. Negative 4 minus 0 over 0 minus 5. Negative 4 minus 0 is still negative 4, and 0 minus 5 is negative 5. 4 doesn't divide evenly by 5, but a negative divided by another negative will always be positive, so the slope would be positive 4 over 5. That's all for now. Keep practicing that slope formula. We will be using it a lot in the future. In the next lesson, we'll be shifting back to looking at graphs, specifically graphs of lines with special slopes.